Most Christians believe only God can control the weather, and they take great comfort in this belief, while the leaders of the world are planning their demise. These are just a few of the plans that the Illuminatus are cooking up for you. Weather control has been planned, and the coming storm wave named the Superstorm is planned out by them to destroy and kill as many of us as they can. Now let us not forget what the Bible says about these people. I will judge the ones who tried to destroy the earth. Russia caused Mount St. Helens to erupt on May the 18th, 1980, and their scalar harp weapon caused it. The Russians have been pinging Yellowstone National Park with the scalar wave since 1976 to cause it to erupt as well. Now, we've already talked about this before, but now we are nearing the time of attacks from Russia, and this is a danger that we must face in reality. Now, we can clearly see that Russia has been turning up the scalar and F-wave pinging frequencies in this area. Now, it seems that the USGS at times is offline. This is so that the sheeple will not have a warning in time for all the ones that are living in and around the Yellowstone Park about the impending danger. Now, this is why we have been seeing so many earthquakes in the surrounding area and the states. Now, they have plans to also wake up other sleeping volcanoes, creating a major crisis. Now, the Russians generally use their impending grids over the United States to control the weather, moving hot or cold air where they can to meet and create storms, hurricanes, torrential rains, droughts, as they please, guiding the ELF impulses to the Earth's crust and greatly induce earthquakes, as well as provoking volcanoes to erupt, just like they're trying to do with Yellowstone. Now, these impulses slash waves can also cause dancing tornadoes around or pull them down from the upper atmosphere, as we've been seeing. This creates also ocean hurricanes inland as they are directed and intensifies as they manipulated the Katrina. They've also been radiating these elf waves to target populations for mind control purposes. And we've talked about that before too. The Pacific Northwest Division of the United States has been constantly pinged with this scalar signal named the Woodpecker since July the 4th, 1976. Moisture is trapped in from the ocean and sent over the land, sending cold air from the north into the south, creating violent thunderstorms with these impulses. And diseases are being embedded into our cellular system, causing rates changing from electromagnetic waves to infrared waves. Now, when did weather modification begin? I asked myself this question, so I've decided to look it up, and I found a long list of proof, and I just want to show you a few of what I found, so you can read it here. We are under constant high-tech attack in a war, and very few even grasp that it's happening around us at any time. And at this very time, it is deadly, and it's called a silent warfare, and it directly aims to 2/3 of all mankind, not just in the United States. Now, I've talked with you before about this Russian silent weapon. New Agers think that this earth can be destroyed by man just by living on it. When Yahweh told Adam and Eve to be fruitful, to multiply, to replenish the earth, subdue it, have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living that moves upon the earth. And then he told Noah and his sons to be fruitful, to multiply, and replenish the earth. So don't you think that he would have known that man was going to harm the earth just by living on it, since he's the one that created it and created us? Now, this phrase sums up the prevalent attitude amongst most New Agers, as they have bought the lie in their religion, hook, line, and sinker, that Mother Earth is so fragile that man can destroy her. And these occultists have also believed that the earth is a living, breathing thing, a goddess that they worship called Mother Gaia. They were trying to prove that the Americas have been destroying their forests so they could block off large blocks of land. So they decided to prove that human activities in the forest are endangering certain species because they want, as I said, to save huge tracts of land, declaring them off limits to human activity and commerce. We Americans didn't fall for this. So they call it saving the endangered species. Don't think this is just in America. Don't fool yourself. It's worldwide. So they've closed parks, calling it budget cuts. And we know it's not true because many of these parks are inside the United Nations biodiversity zones that were planned to be set aside long before they called it budget cuts and closed them. Storms and droughts can be used indirectly as a weapon touching the enemy. Not only do Russian scientists control our weather, but Americans also do. They can and do create much of the turbulences we see in nature for the past decades. As I have already shown you, current weathermen titles are the worst storm in history. I just named this the worst flood in the past 120 years. This storm was unprecedented, for it has never snowed in this region before. It was the worst 500-year flood in this area. Just look at it. This tornado was unbelievable. This was an unexplainable weather, for it changed overnight. A lot of officials will shout this is global warning, warning that more dreadful storms will happen without making changes in our lifestyles radically. They never say that these changes are going to abolish you. Now, the Russian side, according to a Wall Street Journal article, it says that they are able to steer the hurricanes they purposely manufacture so that it wouldn't cause destruction in nearby cities or any country. So this is saying that every hurricane that we've ever had could have been stirred away from our shores. And that the hurricane that we currently have just had in California, when I was sent the information on it and they were coming in, I knew in my spirit that they were manufactured without a doubt. So possibly these hurricanes were a stepping stone into time-consuming movement to persuade the Americans that we need to change our major way of living. They are creating national wildfires. Now, these fires are enormously hot, and they reach up to 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. They are so hot that they are forcing the forest land into grassland, downgrading it to inadequate for farming or any human activity. Lightning causes fires, but so do humans. Take note. A long, prolonged drought can drive farmers out of their land that their families have possessed for generations. Flooding and hurricanes and easterners, heat waves and droughts and tornadoes, high-velocity winds are also caused by these madmen. And everything that we've been seeing in Africa, most of that is caused by these madmen. Now, the New Age leaders have repeatedly written in our constitutional system of our government, it must be removed and replaced by the enlightened dictatorship of the United Nations. Only then can the dictatorian step necessary to restore nature to balance be taken. And we know who this leader is. It is the Antichrist. Now, the date of this cover letter was October the 27th. 1978, and the name of the treaty is Convention on the Prohibition of Military or Any Other Hostile Use of the Environmental Modification Techniques, approved by the General Assembly of the United Nations on December the 10th, 1976. Now, the UN treaty provides the existence of reality of weather warfare. Number one, it creates earthquakes. The New World Order plan is to eliminate cities where earthquakes can turn out to be the most devastating. Severe earthquakes can in blanketing and emptying cities. Number two, hurricanes and or typhoons is also a weapon with a devastating force. If the occurrence of the hurricanes were to become a regular occurrence, it would render cities unsound. Number three, it causes flooding, which is rolling waters that jeopardize complete cities. Flooding the lands would force farmers out of their business, reverting the fertile farmlands back to nature. Number four, drought. When there is drought in the farming areas, this is more devastating than flooding. The lack of food would possibly cause to reduce the population growth. Plus, when you don't have water and you don't have food, then you control the masses. Tsunami waves. This huge wave is destructive and incredibly terrifying, forcing populations off the coastway. Volcanoes. An exploding of a volcano can eliminate many cities and towns within its reach if it's a large one. Tornadoes. They have become more destructive in the past years, wiping out towns. Severe heat over a long period of time, say many days in a row of 100 degrees weather, could cause fertile and fruitful pastures to become wastelands, as we remember back in the Dust Bowl days. The deliberate manipulation of natural process is the manipulating the jet stream and reducing its flow and its way for stopping the natural flow. Most rainfall, or lack thereof, is destructive. Tornadoes, hail, thunder, and lightning, etc., is regulated by the jet stream. Scientists are changing the composition and structure of the Earth with earthquakes. Since 1992, the military can create earthquakes at any place on the Earth using small nuclear devices. Now, these weather control techniques can damage, injure, and destroy animal and plant life of a particular region considered as a total economical entity of a nation, wiping out the entire ecological system if they choose to. They can damage, injure, or destroy the soil, outer layer of the earth of a nation. This is just above the semi-fluid atmosphere and includes the crust and the solid part of the blanket of the earth that is about 47 miles deep. Now, damaging, injuring, and destroying also the atmosphere of a nation or a group of nations. They can do this too. They can damage, injure, and destroy even the outer space if they choose to. This is all the UN's plans and laws, guided by the interest of consolidating peace and wishing to contribute to the cause of halting the arms race and bringing about general and complete disarmament under strict and effective international control, recognizing that scientific and technical advances may open new possibilities with respect to modification of the environment, recognizing, however, that military or other hostile use of such weather modification techniques could have effects extremely harmful on human welfare, desiring to prohibit effective military or any other hostile use of environmental modification techniques in order to eliminate the dangers to mankind for such use, and affirming their willingness to work towards the achievement of this objective. Now, this treaty shows weather capabilities can be produced and what their effects are, like wind speed, and cover large geological area, long-lasting weather. You can no longer feed your population, then the population must change. And we see this happening in places like Africa. We will soon see this happening in the United States. Severe weather control abilities can yield severe damage, destruction, and injury. They are controlling the jet stream. Jet stream travels hundreds of miles an hour, and its life on the surface can be difficult if the jet stream get low. This can change the course of the rivers, and we see thawing of ice cap. Scientists are shooting tens of millions of watts of power into the atmosphere, causing them to melt, but yet they're calling it global warming. Altering weather patterns. Now we know that scientists from both Russia and America can create and direct the weather. Worldwide flooding. They can warm or cool off the whole world's temperature. They've punched a hole in the ozone layer. They can do it over the enemy's country. Now let us take a look at some of the fears that the New Age scientists have about the damage of effects of HAARP and how it can inflict upon the earth. Weather weapons technology has been developed behind the simple idea of adding immense levels of energy, especially ELF. ELF is the extremely low frequency in the atmosphere. Adding energy to the atmosphere at the correct ELF frequency, you could then stimulate the way in which storms are naturally formed. While these types of towers are located in many parts of the world, America has constructed the largest array of towers in the world in Alaska. These HAARP towers cover 40 acres and are connected directly to a gas field, thus giving uninterrupted and cheap power to this field. HAARP was fully functional in the early 1993. Now, these Gwyn towers works in unification with HAARP transmitters to create storms and to alter weather patterns. How evil man can be. Now, I must tell you once again that nothing can or will happen without the knowledge of Yahweh God, that he will allow man to do this, for it has been foretold in his word all of this would happen in these end times. If you do not know him as the Father, you need to right now ask him to forgive you in Jesus' name. and he will do so.